Hello everybody, greetings to friends everywhere, all my nursing home friends, the ones that I know and the ones that I haven't met yet. So I hope you're all going to enjoy another song. And today I thought I would make this song the first of the next collection. In other words, I'm starting a new collection, a new sing-along collection today, starting with this song. And why did I choose today? Well, I was just prompted to choose this because I saw the other day that Tom Jones celebrated his 80th birthday. And so I said to myself, why don't we sing a song, a Tom Jones song? And his 80th birthday, not bad going at all. He's catching up on me. So another few years he'll be where I am. Praise God, we're all alive. So the old hometown looks the same. Tom Jones sings still with a head of curly hair. I don't have hair curly or straight, so I'm going to wear a cap. Tom Jones doesn't have a cap. Unless he gets the idea from me. Here we go. The old hometown looks the same. This is song number one. The old hometown looks the same as I step down from the train, and there to meet me is my mama and my papa. Down the road I look and there runs Mary, hair of golden, lips like cherries. It's good to touch the green, green grass of home. Yes, they'll all come to meet me, arms reaching, smiling sweetly. It's good to touch the green, green grass of home. The old house is still standing, though the paint is cracked and dried. And there's that old oak tree that I used to play on. Down the lane I walk with my sweet Mary, hair of golden, lips like cherries. It's good to touch the green, green grass of home. Then I awake and look around me at the four grey walls that surround me, and I realize that I was only dreaming. For there's a garden, there's a sad old padre, arm in arm we walk at daybreak again. I touch the green, green grass of home. Yes, they'll all come to see me in the shade of that old oak tree, as they lay me neath the green, green grass of home. Oh, that got us off to a good start. Now, song number two is the Green Glens of Antrim, popularised by Michael O'Duffy, the great Irish tenor, and also Foster and Allen, and I'm sure there are many others who sing the Green Lands of Antrim. This is a slowish version, slow waltz I suppose, so you won't have to be leaping around and singing it at the same time. But I do want you to join in and sing. Of course, you have the words on the screen anyway, thanks to Michael Farry. And Mary, are you ready? Aaron? Okay, yeah. And Breda, how about you? Are you ready? All right. Anyway, sing along with your Uncle Matt, the Green Lands of Antrim. Far across yonder blue lies a true fairy land, with the sea rippling over the Singalong sand, where the gay honeysuckle is luring the bee, and the green glens of Antrim are calling to me. Sure, if only you knew how the lamp of the moon turns a blue Irish bay to a silver lagoon, you'd imagine the picture of heaven would be, where the green glens of Antrim are calling to me. Soon I want to return to my own cushioned hole. It's the one place for me that can outshine them all. Sure, I know every stone, I recall every tree, where the green glens of Antrim are heaven to me. Should be where the people are gentle and kind, and among them there's one who is dear to my mind. So I pray that the world would in peace let me be, where the green glens of Antrim are heaven to me. Shinawil, I hope you enjoyed it. Now, song number three. Song number three is a nice little sing-along number called Have You Ever Been Lonely? Have You Ever Been Blue? I forget. I think it might have been sung by the Andrew Sisters or something like that. I'm sure somebody down there knows who sang it. It's simple enough. Just follow the music. I think a little bit, in the middle of it somewhere, there's a little bit section where you might like to hum. I might fiddle around with my saxophone, and anyway, it's hopefully everybody will enjoy it. Have you ever been lonely? Have you ever been blue?
Have you ever loved someone just as I love you? Can't you see I'm sorry for each mistake I've made? Can't you see I've changed, dear? Can't you see I've paid? Be a little forgiving. Take me back in your heart. How can I go on living now that we're apart? If you knew what I've been through, now you know why I ask you. Have you ever been lonely? Have you ever been blue? Now you go home. Oh, oh, oh. Take me back in your heart. How can I go on living now that we're apart? If you knew what I've been through, yes, you know why I ask you. Have you ever been lonely? Have you ever been blue? Have you ever been lonely? Have you ever been blue?
Now, I hope everybody enjoyed that. And Jean, I hope you are listening too, wherever you are. And next time we'll have number 4. And we are at song number 4. And song number 4 is a funny song, a comic song. And but still there's a nice lively chorus to it. And it's called Lord, It's Hard to Be Humble. I don't know who sang this, to be honest with you. T.R. Dallas or somebody, some of those country and western people. I've never sung it before. I would imagine, since it's a comic song, Brendan Grace springs to mind. And I thought I would sing it maybe as near enough as I think Brendan Grace might have sung it. But of course, I wouldn't be a patch on Brendan Grace. But it's supposed to be sung by a cowboy, so I'll put on my hat. And we'll promote him to a sheriff. A sheriff that's hard to be humble. So, you hope you all join in the chorus. Sure, look, it's a fun thing. We'll try and make it as funny as possible. Well, I see now where I go. Oh Lord, it's hard to be humble when you're perfect in every way. I can't wait to look in the mirror, 'cause I get better looking each day. To know me is to love me. I must be one hell of a man.
Oh Lord, it's hard to be humble, but I'm doing the best as I can. I used to have a girlfriend, but I guess she just couldn't compete with all of these low-starved women who kept throwing things at my feet. Oh, I probably could find me another, but I guess they're all in awe of me. Who cares? I never get lonesome, 'cause I treasure my own company. Lord, it's hard to be humble when you're perfect in every way. I can't wait to look in the mirror, but I get better looking each day. To know me is to love me. I must be one hell of a man. Oh Lord, it's hard to be humble, but I'm doing the best that I can. I guess you could say I'm an owner, a cowboy alone, tough and proud. I could have lots of friends if I wanted, but then I wouldn't stand out in the crowd. Some folks say that I'm egotistical. To hell, I don't even know what that means. I get it has something to do with the way that I fill out my skin tight blue jeans. Oh, Lord, it's hard to be humble when you're perfect in every way. I can't wait to look in the mirror and get better looking each day. But you know me is to love me. I must be one hell of a man. Oh Lord, it's hard to be humble, but I'm doing the best that I can. I'm doing the best that I can. Share with.
Song number 5. Well, song number 5 is something totally different from anything we've done so far. It's got a Latin rhythm, and there's something very appealing about a Latin rhythm. Rhythmic stuff is nice. But this song was immortalized by Elvis Presley. It's called It's Now or Never. So it's very singable. Let's all join together and sing It's Now or Never.
It's now or never, come hold me tight. Kiss me, my darling, be mine tonight. Tomorrow will be too late. It's now or never, my love won't wait. When I first met you, with your smile so tender, my heart was captured, my soul surrendered. I'd spend a lifetime waiting for the right time. Now that you're near, the time is here at last. It's now or never, come hold me tight. me, my darling, be mine tonight. Tomorrow will be too late. It's now or never, my love won't wait. Just like a willow, we would cry an ocean if we lost true love and sweet devotion. Your lips excite me, let your arms invite me, for who knows when we'll meet again this way. It's now or never, come hold me tight. Kiss me, my darling, be mine tonight. Tomorrow will be too late. It's now or never, my love won't wait. It's now or never, my love won't wait. It's now or never, my love won't wait.
Oh, how was that, Ron?
Howdy, folks. I thought I would don my sombrero and my, whatever you call this sort of thing, to celebrate the memory of Glen Campbell. I thought he was one of the greatest contemporary musicians that we had. I liked his work very, very much. He was a great singer, a great musician, wonderful guitar player. Born in Arkansas in 1936, died in Nashville in 2017. And he had a great vocal range, which means he could sing high and he could sing low. And it didn't seem to bother him one little whit. And great diction, great everything, great presentation, wonderful character. So one of his most popular songs was Rhinestone Cowboy. And I think we can sing it together. I mean, give it a go anyway. And I'm sure you'll be very good in this. So you have words to think and have all that sort of stuff.
Walking these streets so long, singing the same old song. I know every crack in these dirty sidewalks of Broadway, where hustle's the name of the game, and the nice guys get washed away with the snow and the rain. There's been a load of compromising on the road to my horizon, but I'm gonna be where the lights are shining on me, like a rhinestone cowboy riding out on a horse in a star-spangled rodeo. Like a rhinestone cowboy, getting cards and letters from people I don't even know, and offers coming over the phone.
But I really don't mind the rain, and the smile can hide all the pain. Down when you're riding the train, it's taking the long way. And I dream of the things I'll do, with a subway token and a dollar tucked inside my shoe. There'll be a load of compromising on the road to my horizon, but I'm gonna be where the lights are shining on me. Like a rhinestone cowboy riding out on a horse in a star-spangled rodeo. Like a rhinestone cowboy getting cards and letters from people I don't even know, and offers coming over the phone. Rhinestone cowboy riding out on a horse in a star-spangled rodeo. Like a rhinestone cowboy getting cards and letters from people I don't even know, and offers coming over the phone. Rhinestone cowboy.
So much for that. On now to the next song. Thank you. Song number 7. And it's different again. This is an oldie. It's Let Him Go, Let Him Tarry. And when I was a kid, I used to think this was synonymous with Delia Murphy, because she sang it, among other things, like Three Lovely Lassies from Banyan and songs like that. But anyway, she was a great popular lady on Radio Éireann when I was a kid. And I was listening to John Bowman on the radio recently enough, and he was talking about her. And one or two very interesting facts came up. She was born in County Mayo, 1902. And she died at the age of 69 only in 1971. She was married to the Irish ambassador to Rome during the years World War II, Dr. Thomas J. Kiernan. And it's an extraordinary, or this is an extraordinary fact now that's about to follow. She was friendly with Monsignor Hugh O'Flaherty. And together between them, they saved the lives of 6,500 Jews and Allied troops during World War II. Now, I think that is very, very commendable, and it's a fact for which she should be remembered. So, well done, Delia Murphy. And having said all that, now we'll go on singing your song.
Let him go, let him tarry, let him sink or let him swim. He doesn't care for me and I don't care for him. He can go and get another that I hope he will enjoy, for I'm going to marry a far nicer boy. Farewell to cold winter, summer's come at last. Nothing have I gained but my true love I have lost. I'll sing and I'll be happy like the birds upon the tree, for since he deceived me I care no more for he. Let him go, let him tarry, let him sink or let him swim. He doesn't care for me and I don't care for him. He can go and get another and I hope he will enjoy, for I'm going to marry a far nicer boy. He sent me a letter saying he was very sad. I sent him back another saying I was awful glad. He wrote to me another saying he was well and strong, But I care no more about him than the ground he walks upon. Let him go, let him tarry, let him sink or let him swim. He doesn't care for me and I don't care for him. He can go and get another that I hope he will enjoy. For I'm going to marry a far nicer boy. He can go and tell his mother now, let her mind at ease. I hear she is a lady that's very hard to please. It's slighting me and talking ill is what she's always done. Because that was her courting her great big useless son.
Now we'll continue with song number 8, which is another bouncy number. And I know, Ginny, I see you're itching ready to go. And Mary and Brady, yeah, you're ready to go, ready for action as well. And as for Tracy, you have to tone it down up there. Anyway, what can I say? Another bouncy number that everybody knows and I hope everybody loves. It's called Courtin' in the Kitchen.
Come single bell and bow unto me, pay attention. Don't ever fall in love, it's the devil's own invention. For once I fell in love with a waymaid so bewitching, Miss Henrietta Bell, or Captain Kelly's kitchen. Witchy tooraloorala, tooraloorala-dee, tooraloorala, tooraloorala-dee. At the age of 17, I was apprenticed to a grocer, not far from Stephen's Green, where Miss Henry used to go, sir. Her manners were sublime, she set me heart a twitching, and she invited me to a holy in the kitchen. Witchy tooraloorala, tooraloorala-dee, tooraloorala, tooraloorala-dee. When the captain came downstairs, though he saw me situation, in spite of all me prayers, I was marched off to the station. For me they set no bail, though to get home I was itching. I had to tell the tale of how I came into the kitchen. Witchy tooraloorala, tooraloorala-dee, tooraloorala, tooraloorala-dee. Well, I swore she did invite me, though she gave a flat denial. And so they did indict me, and I was sent for trial. She swore I robbed the house, in spite of all me screeching. And I got 6 months hard for me courting in the kitchen. Witchy tooraloorala, tooraloorala-dee, tooraloorala, tooraloorala-dee.
Now, friends, I don't know how many of you have this kind of an experience, but frequently when I wake up in the morning, there's already a song going through my mind. I don't know where it comes from, and it's usually something from the very distant past. And a recent experience I had brings this song even nearer. Not so long ago, Mina asked if I would sing the song Doonaree. And I did indeed. I did, completed all that little challenge. But there's something about Doonaree that kind of stuck in my mind. Just wouldn't go away. It's a lovely old song. And the other day I was doodling and didn't I discover another musical arrangement of Doonaree that I think suits the vocal exercise a lot more than the accordion accompaniment that we had originally. So I decided to include it again here now as a song number 9. And this will be a different musical backing. There are backing vocals in the middle, which I think add a lot of life to it. But it's a lovely old song written by Eilish Boland, all the way from King's Court. And it's not the only thing she wrote, but this is very, very catchy. So do sing along.
If you ever go to Ireland, I'm sure you will agree to take the road from Dublin town way down to Dunaree. And there you'll find a wishing well behind a chestnut tree, in a shady nook by a winding brook. Will you make this wish for me? Oh, to be in Dunaree with a sweetheart I once knew, to stroll in the shade of the leafy glade where the road it end runs through, to sit with my love on the bridge above where every water flows, to go back home nevermore to roam is my dearest wish of all. And if you take the hilly path to where the bluebells grow, where we as barefoot children played so many years ago, you'll find a slumbering castle there enshrined in memory, in a shady nook by a winding brook. Will you make this wish for me? Oh, to be in Dunaree with a sweetheart I once knew, to stroll in the shade of a leafy lake where the road again runs through, to sit with my love on the bridge above where evening water falls, to go back home nevermore to roam is my dearest wish of all. To go back home nevermore to roam is my dearest wish of all.
Oh, that was that one. I hope you enjoyed it. Now, friends, song number 10 is another popular one that I'm sure you all know, My Lovely Rose of Clare. Its composer is disputed. It's alleged to have been written by a fellow called Chris Ball from Ennis, but that fact is disputed, so I can't say. But I do know it was recorded by Paddy Riley, the Dubliners, and I think Daniel. And now for song number 10 on our programme, you are all going to sing it, and I'll give you a hand, wherever I can.
Oh, my lovely Rose of Clare, you're the sweetest girl I know. You're the queen of all the roses, the pretty flowers that grow. You
are the sunshine of my life, so beautiful and fair. And I will always love you, my lovely Rose of Clare. The sun shone like a jewel on the lovely hills of Clare, when I strolled along with my sweet lass one evening at the fair. Her eyes, they shone like silver streams with her long, long golden hair. And I won the heart of a young sweet lass, my lovely Rose of Clare. Oh, my lovely Rose of Clare, you're the sweetest girl I know. You're the queen of all the roses, the pretty flowers that grow. You are the sunshine of my life, so beautiful and fair. And I will always love you, my lovely Rose of Clare. As we walked down by the river bank, watched the Shannon flowing by, and listened to the nightingale singing songs for you and I. And now to say goodbye, farewell to all you true and fair. For I have stolen the heart of one, my lovely Rose of Clare. Oh, my lovely Rose of Clare, you're the sweetest girl I know. You're the queen of all the roses, the pretty flowers that grow. Are the sunshine of my life, so beautiful and fair. And I will always love you, my lovely Rose of Clare. And I will always love you, my lovely Rose of Clare.
Thank you. And now, friends, we are at song number 11, which is the second last song in this programme. Now, this song is called Roses Are Red, My Love. And that's a song that was popular again when I was a child. Why did it come into my mind? Well, you know the way the mind works. I was thinking about childhood the other day, and a lot of us kids had autograph books, and we kept them. And when somebody would come to visit the house, we'd ask them to sign the autograph book. And I remember my Aunt Angela, God love my Aunt Angela, I'm always quoting her, loved her so much. But when she came once and she signed in my book, love many, trust few, always paddle your own canoe. And that was one such autograph. And this one, roses are red, violets are blue, sugar is sweet, and so are you. I'm sure that was in my autograph book as well. So anyway, the name Bobby Vinton is the one that's associated with singing this song. To be honest with you, the name Bobby Vinton means nothing to me. And maybe it means something to you. But anyway, between us, I hope we can get through this. I think there is a fella singing on the track in the background somewhere. Maybe he needs our help. We'll see what happens.
A
graduation day. You handed me a book, I signed this way, roses are red, my love, violets are blue. Sugar is sweet, my love, but not as sweet as you. We dated through high school, and when the big day came, I wrote into your book, next to my name, roses are red, my love, violets are blue. Sugar is sweet, my love, but not as sweet as you. Then I went far away, and you found someone new. I read your letter, dear, and I wrote back to you, roses are red, my love, violets are blue. Sugar is sweet, my love, good luck, may God bless you. Is that your little girl? She looks a lot like you. Someday some boy will write in her book, true, roses are red, my love, violets are blue. Sugar is sweet, my love, but not as sweet as you.
That little one, and I hope you liked it. And now, friends, it's time for the last hurrah, the last song in this series anyway. And some will say he kept the best wine until last. I think Dinny will say that anyway. This is the song in Dublin's Fair City, Molly Malone. And before we sing the song, I would like to return my thanks to friend and colleague Michael Farry for all his hard work in stringing all the songs together and typing out all those words and making them available to you. It's his contribution cannot be overstated. So I hope you have enjoyed the songs that we've sung today on this occasion. They will be available on YouTube ad infinitum, I hope. And so until the next time, let's sing Molly Malone. In Dublin's fair city, where the girls are so pretty, I first set my eyes on sweet Molly Malone. As she wheeled her wheelbarrow through streets broad and narrow, crying cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, crying cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh. She was a fishmonger, and sure 'twas no wonder, for so were her father and mother before. And they each wheeled their barrow through streets broad and narrow,
frying cockles and mussels. Alive, alive, oh. Alive, alive, oh. Alive, alive, oh. Frying cockles and mussels. Alive, alive, oh. She died of a fever, and no one could save her. And that was the end of sweet Molly Malone. Now her ghost wheels her barrow through streets broad and narrow, crying cockles and mussels. Alive, alive, oh. Alive, alive, oh. Alive, alive, oh. Crying cockles and mussels. Alive, alive, oh. Alive, alive, oh. Alive, alive, oh. Crying cockles and mussels. Alive, alive, oh.
Now, thank you very much, everybody. I hope you all enjoyed that session. I understand that visitation is going to be allowed fairly soon again. So, with the help of God, we'll be seeing some of you in the flesh soon again. And until that day, please stay safe, everybody. Stay well, and God bless you all. Thanks.